Ed Dwight. If you know that name, it's likely for his prolific sculpting career here in Colorado. We featured his work on Next. And he was recently honored in Washington for the work of his younger years. Katie Eastman has the story.
In a warehouse in North Denver, an artist still works. At age 87, Ed Dwight creates to honor black heroes.
I think the world has settled on me being a sculptor.
He makes monuments dedicated to celebrating black musicians, activists, and soldiers around the country. He celebrates what was and what could have been. A man who knows what it's like when the world won't accept a black man.
Because this was 1961 that I got a letter inviting me to join the astronaut corps.
With President Kennedy as his sponsor, Ed Dwight became the first black astronaut candidate. But in 1963, the man behind his mission was killed, and racism took off instead.
A black or a woman joining this group would make it so offensive to the American public that they wouldn't tax. I mean, they wouldn't pay taxes for NASA to be in space.
Even coming in seventh in a class of 17 test pilots wasn't enough, and the first black astronaut candidate never got the job. For decades, the nation forgot. Until a New York Times reporter came calling.
And then what happened to this black astronaut guy? Well, the guy went away and he disappeared into the ether. Where is he? And so she calls me up.
Last year, this 12-page article caught the attention of the people in charge of the space program today, the ones who have settled on a different world for black astronauts.
And I was told over and over again this was too early. Too early for the black, anybody black to be doing anything like this, you know.
It shouldn't have been too early, but now the Pentagon is acknowledging that.
I ended up being exonerated, if you will.
He became an honorary Space Force member last week. The sculptor is proud of this honor, but he didn't need it.
I've done so much since then to supplant that.
Ed Dwight will be remembered not for settling for what he never became, but for honoring the men and women who never settled. Katie Eastman, 9 News.
Wow, what a story. What a man.